I welcome you all in this course on steam and gas power system. Today we will do the analysis on the steam turbine performance. In the previous lecture, we have already done the found the blade or diagram efficiency for single stage steam turbine as W u by V1 square. VW is the wheel component of the velocity diagram. This is the velocity diagram. This is absolute velocity at inlet. This is peripheral velocity of the rotor. This is relative velocity at inlet, relative velocity at outlet, and this is absolute velocity at outlet. And the angles are, this is blade inlet angle, this is blade outlet angle, this is nozzle inlet angle, and this is nozzle outlet angle, right. And this efficiency has to be maximized, because whenever a equipment or system is evolved, initially we do not focus on efficiency, we focus on the output, right. When the output, then subsequently our focus is shifted on the efficiency, that output we are getting at what efficiency, because efficiency is a very important parameter to for the performance evaluation of any equipment or any component. So here the blade efficiency, the blade or diagram efficiency is expressed by this, right. So we will see under what conditions this blade or diagram efficiency is maximum. One thing is here that the ratio of u and inlet velocity, because this is peripheral velocity, this is inlet velocity, relative velocity is derived from this and this, and all the velocities are derived from this peripheral velocity and the inlet. The main thing is peripheral velocity and the inlet velocity, and their ratio is denoted by rho. This blade efficiency will be maximum when this is having the maximum value, this is having the minimum value, right. V1 is, let us say it is constant, we cannot have V1 minimum is 0. It means when there is no velocity at inlet, mathematically then efficiency is going to be the infinite. In this case V1 is also constant. Wheel component is dependent on inlet velocity. Wheel component VW is dependent on inlet velocity or relative velocity at inlet, either of these, and also at u, right. So we will say that VW, first of all, VW is equal to V1 cos alpha 1 plus V2 cos alpha 2, right. Or we can say subsequently VR1 cos beta 1 plus VR2 cos beta 2. We will take VR1 cos beta 1 out, 1 plus VR2 by VR1 cos beta 2 by cos beta 1. Now these values of either they are equal, beta 1 or beta 2 are equal, or their values are very close to each other. Under any case, it is a constant, right. And this VR2 by VR1, this is blade velocity coefficient, right. So we can always say that VR1 cos beta 1 is equal to 1 plus, this is also constant, so KB, right. Ideal case, K is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Now VR1, we do not have the value of VR1, because VR1 is dependent on V1, absolute velocity at inlet. So relative velocity is dependent upon the absolute velocity. So instead of taking VR1, because it cannot be measured, we will take V1 cos alpha 1 minus U. V1 v1 is cos alpha is in this direction, the component of absolute velocity minus u will give us the vr1 cos beta 1, this component. So, this component of v1 in this direction minus peripheral velocity u will give this component. So, this is going to be the vw, right. Now, u multiplied by u. So, this has to be multiplied by u. And from here, we can take u is equal to rho v1. So, vw u is equal to v1 cos alpha 1 minus rho v1 1 plus kb rho v1, because u is again replaced by v1, and this u can also be replaced by rho v1. Now, if we further simplify this, so 2 vwu is going to be 2 rho v1 cos alpha 1 minus rho v1 1 plus kb. Now, this v1 and v1, this and multiplied by this will go here, square is going to 2 rho cos alpha 1 minus rho square 1 plus kb. Is it okay? This rho and this rho is v1 is taken out, this v1 and v1 are taken out, multiplied by this one has gone here, rho has gone in. So, rho cos alpha 1 minus rho square 1 plus kb, and this is nothing but blade efficiency. Now, we have blade efficiency, remember this is a constant, this is a constant, alpha 1 is also constant, this is the blade inlet angle and which is constant. So, sorry, not blading, sorry, nozzle inlet angle. So, nozzle inlet angle, it is a constant. So, we can say that efficiency of the blade is a function of rho. Earlier lecture, we have also discussed, then the output, when we increase rho, output increases. If you remember that graph, when we increase the value of u by v1 or the rho, then efficiency increases and attains the maximum value and then it comes down, right. And this, sorry, not efficiency, work output increases and comes down, and force decreases when we increases the value of u by v1. When u is equal to v1, there is no force, and when u is equal to 0, force is maximum. So, now what we can do, we can differentiate this equation for blade efficiency with respect to rho. So, what we are going to get, 2 rho, sorry, cos alpha 1 minus 2 rho 1 plus kb, right. Again, if we differentiate d square nb by d rho square, then we are going to get 2 minus 2 1 plus kb or is equal to minus 4 1 plus kb. K and b both are constant. So, it is going to have negative value. It means if we take this is equal to 0 and the solution will give the maximum value. Now, if this is taken as 0, in that case rho is equal to cos alpha 1 by 2. So, the maximum efficiency or the highest efficiency, the value of rho has to be half of the cos alpha 1, okay. And rho is nothing but u upon v1. Now, with this value of rho, what is the value of efficiency? What is going to be the efficiency of the impulse turbine. In order to find that, here we will put rho is equal to cos alpha 1 by 2. So, efficiency of the blade is equal to 2 times, this is half cos alpha 1 cos alpha 1 minus half cos alpha 1 whole square and then 1 plus kb, right. And from this you will get 2 times half cos square alpha 1 minus 1 by 4 cos square alpha 1 1 plus kb. If you further simplify it, then you will get blade efficiency as 2 times 1 by 4 cos square alpha 1 1 plus kb, right. Our efficiency, blade efficiency is half cos square alpha 1 1 plus kb. Now, k is in ideal case relative velocity, this k is the ratio of relative velocity of steam which is leaving the blade and relative velocity of steam which is entering the blade. So, this is 1 if there are no friction losses. B is blade angle. Normally, the blade inlet angle and blade outlet angle, the values are very close to each other. They are not exactly same. There can be exactly same also, but in most of the cases, they are very close to each other. So, this K and B, we can consider for the sake of convenience, we can consider them to be B to be 1. So, K is 1, B is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, and then it becomes half cos square alpha 1 multiplied by 2, 2 and 2 will be cancelled out. We will get blade efficiency as cos square alpha 1, right. For speed ratio or u by v 1 as for a speed ratio, rho is equal to cos alpha 1, right. Now, we will talk a little about multistaging. What happens in multistaging? In multistaging, when this is analysis we have done for single staging. In multistaging, what is done? Suppose there is a multistaging velocity compounded turbine. So, simply ray diagram if I want to draw, this is the moving blade, steam is leaving, then again there are guide vanes, steam is entering from here and leaving from here. Then again, so there is a moving blade and there is a fixed blade, and then again there is a moving blade, right. Steam is entering from here and leaving from here, and we can have n number of such stages, and cumulative effect of these stages will be the net output of the turbine, or the if we are concerned with the efficiency, then efficiency is going to be 2 sigma VW u by V1 square. So, this is the sigma will component of each stage, will add them and this will give the net output of the multi-staging in the steam turbine. Second thing is, there are losses for the transmission from this stage to this stage. The steam leaving the moving blade and entering in the next stage will have some losses in between. All these issues will be taking up when we will deal with the impulse reaction turbine, okay. And after this, we will go for selection of blade angles. Impulse turbine blade impulse turbine blade sections. So, for this selection in impulse turbine, as you know, there are blades made out of plates and there are curved plates like this. So initially this edge was made sharper. I'll draw a bigger diagram. I think that will be make things more clear. Initially the blades were like this when it started with the section of the blades of impulse turbine. This edge was made sharper so that for the smooth, so that there is a smooth entry of the steam, and steam will glide over this surface and leave from this side. Later on this side also was made sharper, so the section of the blade became like this. So both the ends were sharp, and so there are number of blades in a turbine. There is not a single blade, there are number of blades. So what happens, the steam which is confined to this, or which goes into this zone, there is a lot of turbulence because this is a convex surface. So turbulence takes place and this causes loss or decline in the efficiency of the turbine. Right. In order to overcome this, profile type of blades were used. So this side, what they did, they extended this side up to this point so that there was no turbulence in the vicinity of the convex surface, and the performance of the blades was improved. And in some of the cases, this also, the exit, at exit, this was also extended so that proper direction is given to the steam which is going out of the blade. But this profiling of the blade in impulse turbine blades definitely helped the improvement in the improvement in the performance of the turbine. In reaction turbines, they are airfoil type of blades. These blades we will discuss in details when we will go for the reaction turbines. Now, choice of blade angles, now inlet angle, let us talk about inlet angle. Now, for inlet angle, as you know, that nozzle or nozzle angle is fixed, it is outside the turbine. This is peripheral velocity of the turbine, this is absolute velocity with which the steam is entering the turbine, and here is the relative velocity Vr1, and this is blade inlet velocity, inlet angle. Now the issue is that blade inlet angle is dependent on the inlet velocity. Suppose the inlet velocity changes, inlet velocity is reduced, I want less power, inlet velocity is reduced, diagram will be modified like this. Right, and in that case blade inlet angle will change to beta 2, this is beta 2, right. But we cannot say, we cannot open a turbine for different loads and change the blade angle, it is not possible at all. Blades are fixed and they are fixed at a particular angle, but when the V1 is reduced, so definitely the blade inlet angle will change, and when the blade angle, inlet angle is more, there will be shock, there will be the change in blade angle will cause a shock entry in the blade, and this will damage this may damage the blade also, right. So and this happens in the case only when there is a variation in V1. So because tan beta 1, if we want to calculate tan beta 1, it is going to be V1 sin beta 1, sorry, alpha 1 divided by V1 cos alpha 1 minus u, right. So normally what we do when there is a partial load, the velocity in the last 2-3 stages reduces drastically. So whatever blade angle we calculate with from the velocity diagram in the last stage, the blade angle is purposefully increased by 5 to 10 degrees. This is for the design purpose, right. In last but one stage, the blade angle is reduced by increased by 4 to 5 degrees. In remaining stages, blade angle is increased by 2 to 3 degrees. So after all these calculations, when we do in the velocity diagram, finally when we go for the design and manufacturing of the turbine, so these allowances are taken. So whatever value we are getting, suppose we are getting here 35, initial stage we will take the blade angle 37 or 38 degree, so that shock entry is avoided at part load. Now for the outlet of the blade, now this is about the inlet. For outlet of the blade, a different procedure is adopted because the issues related outlet are different. Let us take two blades, there are two blades, one is this one, another is this one. Between them there is a space S, or the pitch of the blade is S. S is the pitch of the blade. Blade outlet angle is beta 2, right, and cross section area perpendicular to the flow is this one. Right, or it is S sin beta 2. So S sin beta 2. That is the distance multiplied by the height of the blade. Blade will have certain height. So it is S sin beta 2 multiplied by blade height or length of the blade. It has got certain thickness here also. Normally at the edges the thickness is 0.001 inch or 0.0254 millimeter. That is the blade thickness. So here we will take blade thickness also into as account, S sin beta 2 minus T multiplied by L. So this is the cross section area of this passage perpendicular to the flow, right. And this multiplied by number of passages n, this multiplied by number of passages. Now how would you get the number of passages? This is number of passages is n is equal to pi d by s. D is the diameter, s is the pitch, you will get n is the number of passages. Suppose there is an arc, there is a part, because in impulse turbine there is a partial entry of steam as well in some of the cases. In that case, suppose this arc is of length lambda, so n is going to be lambda by s. So let us assume there is a entry, either of the case, whether it is a full entry or partial entry, we can have the value of n. So this is the total area. This total area is equal to mass flow rate multiplied by specific volume divided by VR2, relative velocity of steam leaving the blades, right. Now from here if we resolve this, then we will get MV2 by NLVR2 is equal to S sin beta 2 minus T or sin beta 2 is equal to MV2 divided by NLVR2 plus T divided by 1 by S. So from this we can get the value of angle beta 2, because here we have the mass flow rate which is already with us. A specific volume, this we can get from the properties of the vapor. Then number of nozzles, length. Length is, say this passage, suppose this is perpendicular to the black, to this board, white board, and if you look at the elevation, it is going to be like this, right. So this length of the blade, so blade will have certain height or length. So length of the blade is L, this is the, this S sin beta 2, S sin beta 2 minus T is in axial direction, L in radial direction. That is how we are getting the area multiplied by number of such type of passages. Now from here we will get the blade outlet angle as beta 2. Now here in this case, in at inlet, for designing purpose we are taking the blade angle larger than the what we have calculated here. But here in this case the blade angle is taken 2 to 3 degree less than the calculated from this. So that, I mean, in partial load also it works well, and further because blade angle is less, we will get some reaction also by the change in the velocity of the vapor. So that is why this angle beta 2 is taken normally 2 to 3 degree less than actually, which is actually calculated from this formula. After this, I think we have completed the choice of the bladed. That is all for today.